to Afternoons with Baba. I've been waiting for you, but check out Vojnik in the Primer, Zelnik, što znajte kada pravite svega, right? Zelnik, so kromit I pork. It's a pita called Zelnik with onions and pork. So, I've been chopping my onions here. You cut it in half and then you can slice it several times. And then you cut it the other way to make it smaller, or if you have a chopping machine, that's very good. Now, since we're making two, I'm freezing them. He's a mrznavi as a božik. I dve pram, otim je familija ta golema. So this is about 3 pounds of yellow onions, or 10 of them. If you buy the bag, the way they sell it, it's usually 3 pounds. And I've been working ahead. I fried my pork here. As you can see, it has to be small. If it's not small enough, you have to remove it out of your pan on a board, chopping board, and chop it smaller, because you can't have very big pieces. So there's the pork. This is pork tenderloin, but instead of pork tenderloin, you can use a pork chop. One pork chop for one Zelnik, not too much pork, okay? So we're gonna add our onions. We'll add our onions here. We'll add a little bit of salt. Not too much, because you don't want it salty. So it's a slow frying process. These onions have to caramelize and get very tender. So this is what you do. You fry them inside the delicious sauce from the pork tenderloin. It's got the nice, you try to trim it so it doesn't have any fat on it if it's a pork chop. And then you fry it, the onions in that, and it gives you a very nice smell and good taste. So here we are, if I can keep the onions inside. Yeah. Well, we've been frying it now for a few minutes, and as you can see, it's slowly melting down, and you can see the pork pieces, and the smell is wonderful because you didn't throw out any of the drippings from the pork, and you put a little extra oil. If there's not enough oil, you add a little bit because you have to fry this. You don't want it burning. This is a very rich Zelnik, no bubav zelnik je moj, and it's filling because it's got the pork. Now I've been doing this for about 10 minutes, and as you can see, it has gotten smaller. So it's had a good frying here. It looks good. So it's time to put in the red paprika, black pepper, and let it simmer for another half an hour because the onion needs cooking. It gives people problems in their stomach if it's not properly cooked. So in here I think was 3/4 teaspoon of salt for the onions. While you were gone, I put about 3 ounces of oil in again because it was being absorbed by the onions. So this is the final result. So here's a teaspoon of red paprika. And we will gently stir it so I don't get it all over like I did before. See, it's giving it nice color. That's what you like. And it gives it a good taste. When paprika gets fried in oil, the flavor just comes right out. Yeah. So see how nice and delicious looking? You could actually eat this. It's like a manja. No gubao se stori se. See? Sega. Mukladoma cervena piper. And cervena piper. Zakrumiče to, da testo bao. I koa opržeše trebaše drugi. Drugo maso da mu klam, tako toko 2 ounces. Okay, so yao se, this is the finished product. Well, not yet, but this is now going to be on its own for about half an hour at a very, very low. So it'll be simmering. Now, I have a glass of water, and we'll see how much water this one takes. We'll start with half. Let's see if that's enough. There has to be a little bit of water in there for this to be simmering. Otherwise, it's going to get burned on the bottom. So we'll put another little bit, so half a cup now. I think we're just right. Can you see that now? You can see it around, so that's perfect. So it's down on my simmer, and we are going to put the top on. And you can't leave it alone. Every now and then you check it out. And later on we just sort of open it a bit. But for now we're going to start with it covered. So that is our inside of the Zelnik being made. So we'll put our stuff away now because we have to start the Zelnik. Because I treba prstenice da izvajda. Sega čajnikov mi se stopli sa tromlaka voda I kjo napravime se the yeast kvaso. So tuka kje odi jedno ložiče šeker. I odi 2 zelnici kje napravime 2 ložičina kvas. 2 teaspoons of yeast and 1 teaspoon of sugar because we're doing 2 pieces, 2 zelnik. So we'll put the water, lukewarm water, I already checked it out. There we are. And we'll turn it around like this. Now, and like I said, you have to put something under it in case it overruns. Now, I've already sifted my 6 cups of flour, 3 per zelnik. I što napravo brašno to, što socedao to, I seka ki mu fam totki sol. Oh, about, I guess, half a teaspoon of salt. I sega ke čekame da stane kvaso, sega ke sedne ke se napije jedno kafe I ti oj sednete. Ke se videme. Ok, sega ke čekirame, to videme zele to. Oh, sega pulite kak je? Si? No guba mandele le šubo merisa. Mis merisa. Ja, ke bili no guba vzalnik. Ok, sega ki ostajme vaka troa, da mu izlegva stimo, oti ošče točki. Sega ima 15 minuti, ošče 5 minuti ki ostajme. Sega pa kvaso ni se stori, vidio. Ok, sega ki rabotame so kvaso. Ok. Sega ki ofatame 2 zelnici, tuka kvadome 6 češi brašno I točki sol. I ke mu kapneme tromaslence, da vaka. 1 ounce of there, dosta moje. I ja kvaso se stori. I kjo izmijeme. So, 1 češa. 2 češi voda. I kje vidime kak je vidi. treba pojke. I servo avaka. Kis jo mesis. Treba first of mixes. You have to mix it first like this. See if you need more water or if it's too watery, then you have your spare flour here. So that's how you do it. You're prepared for anything. Kolke mesis, treba da si imaš brašnjence, vodata do tebe. Sega se fino ubao, but I think imu kapno še točki voda. I'm just gonna put a little more water because it seems kind of thick. So I'll just give it a little, what, 1 ounce, 2 ounce? Yeah. So like I said, it's something that you have to get a feel for. No matter how much you measure, it's always different when you're doing it because there could be a little extra flour this time than last time, right? Se voda se sobera troa, que mu fam troa vodička. I think he bought zele to say.
Check it, David.
Yeah. Yeah, in a cup. Say, I'll keep it. 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 The nicer it'll be. Don't think to do it fast and it'll be good. It won't. You have to give it a good workout. You know when you do your exercise, how much better you feel when you do a good exercise? Well, that's what happens with the dough. Once you do it well, then you're on your way to a successful Zelnik or Vienna, whatever you're making, or bread. There has to be the normal kneading. Ja se ko pomesi troa I ki si jo podela. Jedno to pupče za jedan zelnik I drugo to pupče za drugi zelnik. So ovaka ki si napravim je po kola I praviš ovaka. Od kukuko jedno golemo, od imačno je. Maybe za tebe ako si mlada, alright, but se za nas starite, mačno je, so vaka mi je po kola. Se išu bao? Ja, vaka ki si praviš. Ja I se dvete vija. Ki kvam jedno na drugo I ki zamešam troa. I se ki podelo pak od I ki sečeme. Ja 7 pupčina treba od voda izvajme. 3 od odzgore, 4 od ozdoa. We have to get 7 little buns. 3 on top. 1, 2, 3, and 4 on the bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? And we'll do the same for this one. 1, 2, 3 on top. And 1, 2, 3, 4 on the bottom. All ready? Okay, good. Put your bigger. If by chance they're not even and you have larger ones, put your larger ones for the bottom. It's important that the bottom is thick enough because that's where all your vegetables are going to go on to. And the top can be thinner and be flaky. Because I, oti jaska sometimes I pram jedni pomali, jedni pogolemi. So kisi odbera pogolemi te, kisi kvam odozdola. Okay? Okay, now, there we go. Here they are. And now we have to add the oil. You have to put oil on top of them like this. Треба да му фаеш масленце, за да не се изшуше. Оти неке можеш да работа с они, ако се изшуше, they get scabby and you can't pull them, it's horrible. So careful. Do a good job with your oil. Put it on your palms, and now you have to pick them up and do it all around. Покриваме вака со wax paper. Оти се да почине цетроа. Оти фасо работа кој ке се топли. So when they're warm, then the yeast will help them to rise. And then we cover them a little bit like that. And now we can clean up a little bit or have a cup of coffee. And I think it'll be about 45 minutes anyway, so we'll see you soon. Okay, yanyo se zeleto. Here is the onions. Very nice. Now, you add 2 eggs per zelnik. Две яйца за секој зелник. И тука има за два зелници, со треба 4 яйца. The eggs now are going to pull everything together. That's why you put the eggs in. Because the onions are loose, and so you need something that's going to pull all of this together, and that is the eggs. So you have to mix it gently like this, because there's quite a bit here. I have to be careful. And they all have to be mixed in like this. And then to help it along a little bit more, I put a little bit of flour through it. Yep. So now we have to taste it. I always say we have to taste everything. I'll try this. Perfect. You don't want it salty. But you need a little bit of salt. So this is just nice. So we've got all the eggs now mixed in nicely, and we're ready to do our zelnik. So I'll wash my hands and we'll get into it. Now, there they are. The one zelnik. One, two, 3, 4, that's the bottom part. So the recipe for the zelnik is on one of the sections there. I'm not gonna go in too much, but we're making it today again, only a different type of a zelnik with onions. And each section needs to have oil. Треба да си омаслосаш секој пупче. Yeah. Така. And you leave it there and you get your other 3. for the top. And these are your three for the top. Okay, so now we're going to start pulling. This is the top. We'll cover it up again. Sad je upajmene te psičeto. Maka. Кладу се корите двете у тепсиите и сега ќе ту разелето. Окей, сега полуината тука и полуината тука. So, ќе ќе однотереш, док ќе шојте, you pull it back to the corners, because you want all of it to have. And you make sure that you have meat everywhere. И месечето треба да е секаде, посекаде. Ако нема, ќе го кладиш тука таму, ќе си го погодиш у бао. You have to distribute the meat evenly through it because it could be in one spot, right? Yeah. So this one looks good, and now we'll work on this one. Do that one too. And you make sure it's all the way down to the end because that's a thicker part and you want it to taste good. So you use your spoon to distribute it, and if you feel there's too much meat in one section, you just take it and you toss it into where you feel it should be, because this is a little bit more difficult than when you're just using ricotta. Ricotta is all the same, but this one has two things. So there we are. So I'm going to put a little bit of oil on it, like this, drizzle a little bit of oil. Just to give it a little bit of richness. And now we're going to cover them. I'm just taking the longer pieces off. That'll help to make it more even. This is, you sort of pinch. Pinch and pull. Pull and pinch. To make the little design. Around. So it can be attached. Usually when you have a pie, you take a fork around the edges and do that, but this is not a pie. There we are. So they're both ready now. Now when you bake these, you have to make their mark every now and then with a knife or else they're gonna all bubble up. I'm not doing it now because these two are gonna be frozen and baked for Christmas. I'm gonna put them away in my freezer now. Okay, so we accomplished the Zelnici. One, jedno, two, dve. So, kojke sakaš da ispečiš, kojke izvajiš, treba ti ostaviš da se odmrzne. I kojke se odmrzne, kje uzemiš noža to I kje si isečiš vaka oko na oko I kje mu kvajš troje maslence ako mu treba on top. Ako ne mu treba, kvaj mu troje kojke se peče, kje vidiš da se sui. Kvaj mu troje maso od zgora. Okay, so we've done the two and we're gonna freeze them and you have to bring them out and defrost and then you cook them. You cook them at 400 degrees for from 20 to 30 minutes. You watch them if they have a nice face, nice, not burnt. Has to be either light or medium brown and take the spatula and check the bottom and see if it's cooked too, okay? So these guys here are going away for Christmas and I'm going to put my plastic wrap on them. We've done our making, not baking, yeah. So I put a wax paper on top and I'll throw this sheet on top also. And this one over on top of the other. They've been washed and they're clean. They're old, but they're clean. And then we wrap them up in this nice bag nicely and take them downstairs. All right, so I'm putting the other one in the bag too. And I'm gonna say goodbye now till next time. And I hope you enjoy making this Zelnik. It's one of my family's favorite. It's with onions, it's a heartier one. You can make Zelnik with pumpkin, with the ricotta, and spinach, and also with the onion. So thank you for coming this afternoon with Afternoons with Baba, and we'll see you again.